Would you all please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now would you please pause for a moment of silence. Morning, Independence. Here are your announcements for Friday, March the 5th. Difficult classes got you running around? Well, run no more. We have the answer to your academic troubles.
Hey, you know where the math tutoring is?
Yeah, it's in the back of your stairwell. Everyone's there.
Thanks.
Yep.
The upper D stairwell is where it's at for math tutoring. Seniors, please bring a copy of your college acceptance and scholarship letters to Mrs. McCombs in the Counseling Center. This information will be posted in the graduation program, so please bring them in ASAP. Also, seniors, if you still owe your graduation senior fee, please bring it in to Mrs. McCombs in the Counseling Center. Cap and gowns will not be given to students until their fee is paid. Please do not wait until the last minute. Let's head on over to those sports guys.
Hey guys, welcome back to the show.
Yes, welcome back and happy March. Everyone knows what that means.
March Madness.
But as for IHS Sports, our baseball team is just days away from opening day and looking to defend their district title. They'll play a home scrimmage this Monday against the Montgomery Bell Big Red at 4:45.
And the other Diamond, the softball team, will wrap up their preseason by playing the Ravenwood Play Day tournament. It will take place this Saturday at Crockett Park in Brentwood. The team will face tough competition across the mid-state, so come out and support our team.
Now let's go with Ryan Pittman with Pittman on Sports.
This is Ryan Pittman with Pittman on Sports. Today, the Indy boys soccer team will continue their pre-season action with match today against MBA. Both the JV and varsity teams will be in action the JV game at 5 p.m. and the varsity at 6:30 p.m. Games will be played at MBA. This has been Pittman Sports. Go Eagles!
Thanks, Ryan.
Last week I told you about our Ultimate Frisbee team who played Columbia Central last Saturday. They won 13-6 and shut them out after half. Their next game will be tomorrow at 8:30 a.m. It will be at Thompson Station Park again, and we'll be playing our district rivals, Blackman High School. Come out and see the action.
Well, that's all we got this week. Have a great weekend. Back to you, Cody.
Thanks for that report, guys. The ACT will be administered to all 11th grade students currently enrolled at Independence High School on Tuesday, March 9th, beginning at 7:30 a.m. ACT testing room assignments are now posted on the cafeteria windows and the entrances to lower and upper B hallways for the March 2nd pretest session and the March 9th ACT administration at IHS. All 11th grade ACT examinees should report to their ACT testing room no later than 7:30 a.m. on Tuesday, March 9th. Each examinee should bring a picture ID, an approved ACT calculator, and two number two pencils to the exam. Anyone who does not have a picture ID should see their grade level counselor immediately for a letter of identification. Do not bring cell phones, iPods, or any other electronic or communication devices to the ACT test, since these are not allowed in the ACT testing rooms. Be sure to get a good night's sleep and eat a good breakfast in the morning, since open food and drinks are not allowed in the ACT exam rooms. In the midst of the flu season, it can be extremely difficult to keep yourself healthy. However, there is one thing you can do that will save everyone a lot of sickness grief. Stay healthy, IHS. Stay healthy. Peach Fuzz Volleyball Tournament, last day to sign up. Men's teams of 7 sign up for a fee of $10 to compete in the tournament for gift card prizes. Crazy outfits are required. Fan tickets will be sold at the FCCLA booth this week, as well as scrumptious baked goods. The event starts at 6 o'clock tonight in the main gym. There are many inspiring people here at Independence, and IHS students are not to be left out of that mix. One such inspiring person is Kirk Wells, who recently completed his Eagle Scout project. To learn more, we sent Seth Phillips out to cover the story.
Hi, this is Seth Phillips reporting for IHS Media. Every once in a while, a teenager comes up with a revolutionary idea to help his or her community. Kirk Wells is a senior here at IHS, and for the past couple months, he's been working on his Eagle Scout project, in which he donates children's books to the Vanderbilt Children's Hospital to kids in need. Let's take a look. We interviewed Kirk Wells to find out what inspired him to do such a profound Eagle Scout project.
Well, it may seem silly to think that it means a big deal for kids to get something as simple as, you know, a book with a CD with it. But when you think about it, they don't have very much they are able to do in there while they're just sitting in their room alone. And when you give them that little bit of control where they're able to decide which book they want to read or which toy they want to play with, it really makes a big difference when they don't really have much choice in being in the hospital in the first place. I don't know, the scale of what I learned in Boy Scouts was pretty dang important to my life, actually. I can't think of myself had I not done that before.
My impressions of this project, it's a great project. One of the things that we take pride in at Children's Hospital is helping to normalize a child's hospital stay and promoting normal growth and development, helping to reduce stress and anxiety associated with a traumatic event or a stressful hospitalization. So the books will be in our playrooms, like this playroom, and be available for children to take to their rooms or enjoy while they're in the playroom. And it enables us to give that child an opportunity for distraction, something to take their mind off what's tough about being in the hospital. Definitely this project is inspiring. I think that when people from our community do nice things for us and volunteer their time to initiate a project from start to completion. It reminds us that we have this children's hospital because of people who help us and people who make wonderful donations to help our patients and families. So it's very inspiring.
I think it's a very important project because I think when children come to the hospital, they're very scared, and this is a great opportunity for the students to come into a setting like this and relax and listen to books. And if they're school age, it helps them be able to maintain the regularity of their everyday life. And I'm very impressed with Kirk's project, this Eagle Project, and I think it's helped him give back to the community, and hopefully it helps him understand that the world doesn't evolve around him. It's all about what we can give to our community and each other.
It's because of people like Kirk Wells and other caring individuals that we can continue to support our community and the people inside of it. This has been Seth Phillips reporting for IHS Media. Thank you, and back to you, Cody.
Thanks, Seth, and great job, Kirk. It's nice to see people our age making a difference in the community. Freshmen, sophomores, and juniors, your schedule requests are due today. If you do not turn your request in, your counselor will pick your classes for next year for you. You will not be able to change their selection. Please turn these into the Counseling Center ASAP. Ms. Rick's physical science classes recently took part in a very messy lab. Cody Stovall has the story for all of you.
Hello IHS, I'm Cody Stovall, and we recently caught up with Ms. Ricks and her physical science class to see what they're up to.
We're talking about Newton's laws and forces in class, and this was just a fun way for the kids to get to see forces in action. They had to research and then build contraptions that would allow an egg to be dropped from 15 feet or higher and the egg itself not break. Well, we got styrofoam and we cut it in half, and then we dug out a hole in the middle, and then we put like this foam stuff like to keep the egg like when it hits, like to bounce it off of it, and then we used these cable wires to like hold it together really tight.
Well, isn't that just excellent? This is Cody Stovall with IHS Media. Back to you, Cody.
Thanks, Cody, and I hope that no eggs were harmed in the making of that film. Having trouble getting into your house because you lost your key? Come by Student Services and see if we have it in our Lost and Found. We have house keys, car keys, keys on lanyards, keys on rings, and keys all by themselves, and we would love to give them back to you. If you are interested in trying out for the 2010-2011 dance team, there will be an informational meeting next Thursday, March 11th at 5:30 in room D125. Tryouts will be the week following spring break, April 12th through the 16th. If you have any questions, please see Mrs. Leonard in room D125. Every year, the JROTC program puts on a military ball to rival the celebration of prom. This year was no different, and in case you missed the joyous celebration, we got it all on film for you.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come on and fly with me. Let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. you may hear all the angels cheer because we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. It is perfect for a flying honeymoon. They say, come fly with me, let's fly away. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so very near. You might even hear a whole gang of cheers just because we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a cuckoo day. You just say those words and we'll take our birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's so perfect for a flying honeymoon. Oh, babe, come fly with me. Let's fly, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away. Such a cuckoo day. You just say those words and we'll take our birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's so perfect for a flying honeymoon. Oh, babe, come fly with me. Let's fly, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away. Pack a small bag.
Come on out to prom, and you might just get to see me bust a move again. Attention, new National Honor Society members. The induction ceremony for new members is this Tuesday, March the 9th. New National Honor Society members should report to the IPAC by 5:30, dressed and ready to go. See Mr. Ragland or Mrs. Jones if you have questions. Thanks for watching this week's announcements. Stay tuned for a special message from all of us here at the Media Department.
What's up, IHS? I'm Grant Corcoran. Did you know we have a media department here? Well, of course you did, because you're watching the announcements. But there's a problem. I don't believe that the teachers and students have been using us to the best of our abilities. So what I'm trying to say is, if you have an idea or something really cool you think should be on the announcements, just let us know and we'll take care of it, if it's cool enough. And that's pretty much all I have to say.
All ideas might be taken into consideration. The media department has the right to discard all uncool ideas. Thank you.
One, two, three, four.
5, 6, 7, 8.
23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. Well, we don't have any spots.
Pardon? I said Fred.